Gear rising. Infamous tank mode. Love it or hate it, you can't deny that Batman driving around Gotham in a literal tank is... gun that can pull off all sorts of attacks, Jessie also becomes telekinetic, which allows her to toss enemies around, create a shield of rubble, and even fly for short periods of time. Once you start unlocking more of these powers as you progress, you truly become a force to be reckoned with. You'll have a huge arsenal. devastating weapons at your disposal, free to dispatch demons as you see fit. Dooms can get tricky in places if you're playing on a higher difficulty setting or you're not an FPS aficionado, but nothing compares to overcoming those impossible odds. Dooms Software's silky smooth controls do wonders for conveying this sense of power when you're playing Doom, especially if you get your hands. Leveling up Talion and unlocking the power of the Wraith, you'll be taking out any and every orc before you know it. You need higher tier abilities to really make the most of the combat, but eventually, you'll have seemingly endless tools at your disposal. Whether you want to prioritize a stealth build and strike enemies from behind, or you want a glorious, gruesome battle for the ages, it's all at your fingertips. And the satisfaction of killing your nemesis definitely can't be overstated. Number 3. Azura's Wrath. Azura could possibly be the most powerful character in a video game, and that is saying a lot. Azura's Wrath is an anime-inspired game with a lot of content, and it's this cinematic, narrative focus that lets it have such insane, violent encounters totally unhindered by the actual combat system. Not that the combat isn't great when you get a chance to play, it's a lot of fun, but it's the story itself that makes you feel indeed the power of a god. Do you want to blow up a planet-sized boss by punching it to death? Of course you do! Number 2. God of War 3. God of War game, while the 2018 soft reboot is all about Kratos becoming more and more of a monster, taking down gods both out of revenge for their manipulation and so he can prove himself the strongest Greek hero of all. So, of course, you're gonna feel unbeatable when you kill the entire Greek pantheon, including the likes of Zeus. God of War 3 marks the end of the Greek cycle in the franchise, and it definitely ended with a bang. Though Kratos' massacre brought untold suffering to the Greek world, nothing compares to being the actual God of War. Monstrous energy drinks and trips to cyberspace, it didn't seem like Saints Row could get samier than its third entry. Oh, how wrong we were. In its fourth album, you're the president of the United States, and after a devastating alien invasion, you're left trapped inside a computer simulation of Steel Force. But being in a simulation has some benefits. Namely, you've got all the superpowers now. Super speed, telekinesis, super jumps, gliding, you can do anything you want. The only downside is that said powers make the game unbalanced. But then again, that's sort of the whole point. I am awesome!